In order to study biomathematics, you have to be very comfortable with graphs. Now, graphs are lines on a piece of paper, in a textbook, on a computer screen that represents a mathematical function. In its essence, you're going to have a Cartesian coordinate system. We all know this from school, a y-axis and an x-axis. We're going to plot points that represents two values. Every point has a corresponding x value and a y value. And if we do some experiment and we plot all these values that we find from our experiment, we might get a line, and from that line we can make a mathematical function, and we can learn a lot from these graphs and the functions that they represent. Now, we just need to become familiar with a few aspects of graphs. It's always a good start in biomathematics. The program that we're going to use runs in any browser, or most browsers I should say, and it's called Desmos, www.desmos.com. When you load that into the browser, completely free of charge, you don't need specific software for this or specific computer, it will run in most common browsers. So if we just launch the calculator there, you can create a free account. And first things first though, you'll note the Cartesian coordinate system going here from on the y-axis from 8 to negative 8, from 10 to negative 10 on the x-axis. What you can do is on this little option button there, put on projector mode, and that just zooms things in a bit. Not zoom them in necessarily, but just makes things a bit larger so that on the screen these graphs appear a bit better. On the left-hand side here is where you're going to enter your equations. So let's just enter y equals x. It's a big red line there, and we can see it go through the axis there. If you click on it and drag it anywhere along the line, you'll see points on that line. So 3.08, 3.08. And when you draw two curves where they intersect and you put a point there, you can clearly see where the lines of intersection are. So there's this button underneath here. When you click on it, this pops up, so you can either put in a new expression, a table, or just some text. Let's just put in some text. And now we're going to see, let's put in playing with a straight line. That's what we're going to do. For this, let's put in an expression y equals mx plus c. And that's a beautiful thing about this calculator, in as much as you can put these placeholders for constants, m and c. We know what this is. It is a straight line. We all know what the m is. It's going to be the slope, and c is going to be our y-intercept. And if you click on all, you'll see these sliders come up and you can actually play with them. If I click on it and draw it around, I can see that is what a slope is going to look like of negative 0.8. And the slope of 0 would be a straight line, because that's going to be y equals to c. And at 0, that means the intercept of y is going to be at 0. And we'll see as the number grows larger, it means our slope gets larger. And if you click on any of these two, you can set the, on the side, you can set the limits to which it goes and the step interval. So if I only want to go on in steps of 1, it's going to go 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The same goes for c, and you can clearly see that if I had a function y equals mx plus c, and we're certainly going to look at these, it might look like a very stupid, silly function, but it can model various things in biology. And we just see C just represents where our line, our straight line, intersects the y-axis, and making it bigger means the graph goes up, down, the graph goes down. So it's a beautiful calculator that you can play with, various things that you can do, zoom in, zoom out. You can show various things on the Cartesian plane itself. You can change to different coordinates as far as the values are concerned, and you can work in degrees or radians, so it's certainly, that's very nice. And if you just wanted to add some points, let's plot points 1 and 1, and let's point, you just move with your point 2 and 2, point 3 and 3, etc. You can just plot these points. Later on you'll learn how to join these. We can just connect them. There, we just connected them. We'll connect them in a different color, etc. And we can add new columns to the side, left or right, and we'll certainly play with those. But the whole point of this video was just to, well, first of all, to show you this program that you can use, a bit of its functionality. But what we learned here is that m in a equation like this, first order linear equation, meaning the independent variable x is to the power 1, its highest power is 1, so it's first order. We see what difference this constant in front of it makes, which is the slope, and what difference the c makes, which is the y-intercept.